lugar inyo, bahay mo? Bahay mo po?
It's a meeting
Attorney
place.
Abisado,
it's our,
please.
It's our meeting place.
No, pero sino may-ari?
Sino may-ari
ng bahay?
Si Speaker Romualdez po.
Bahay ni Speaker Romualdez.
Yes.
Ah, ganon. So, ang naging host
po,
at nagkumbida ay si Speaker Romualdez. Tama po ba?
Ako po ang nagkumbida. Dapat
paano ka magkukumbida? Hindi mo bahay.
Remind lang kita, baka sulod-sulod yung pagsisinungaling mo ba? Ha? Una, alam mo, under oath ka. Tapos sinabi mo kanina, you never had a meeting with the speaker, kung sino-sino mang nasa likuran nito. Ngayon, when we show you the picture, makinig ka muna.
Saan po galing yung 55 million?
Pera ko po yun. Contribution sa akin ng mga kaibigan, mga supporters namin.
So mga $1 million po yan, di ba?
Yes, he is one of our volunteers. He's a lawyer. Yeah, but first of all, I'd like to thank this August body for inviting us here. This is my first time. And second of all, I'd like to thank you for giving us this opportunity to air our views, our arguments, our thoughts about charter change. Yeah, si Anthony Abad po ay kasama sa professional sector ng pirma. Ang pirma po ay maraming components. Merong farmer sector, professional sector, the youth sector, the fisherman sector, kaya marami hong mga volunteers. Si Attorney Abad, si Anthony A. Abad ay isa sa mga volunteers sa aming professional sector. He is a lawyer.
Yes, sir. At siya po ba yung Attorney Anthony A. Abad na ang pangalan ay nandun sa mga forms na ikinalat para pirmahan ng mga kababayan natin?
Yes, Madam Senator. That is correct.
And sir, narinig nyo nga po on the motion of Senator Roy De La Rosa and ruled favorably on by the chair. Inimbita si Attorney Abad pero wala sila rito ngayon, so isasabina sila. Pero may input din po si SP, kung hindi ako nagkakamali, Madam Chair, na wala na sa Pilipinas si Attorney Abad, nasa ibang bansa na. Can you confirm his whereabouts?
He's out of the country, yes.
He's out of the country. But perhaps, Madam Chair, Mr. Oñate or Attorney Abisado is raising his hand to be acknowledged by the Chair. Can the resource persons from PIRMA venture a thought if the attorney will honor the committee's subpoena in the next hearing, Madam Chair?
Madam Chair, if I may, ganito po
Madam
nangyari.
Madam Chair, Attorney Abisado.
Attorney Abisado
okay, Attorney
po.
Attorney Abisado, you're recognized.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Ganito po yan. Last year when we were consulted by Mr. Noel Oñate regarding his plan to push for people's initiative, nabanggit ko po yan at na-discuss ko kay Attorney Alfredo Garbin. He being also a client of our firm. And he told me tutulong siya at may grupo daw siya. Later on, we found out that kasama po sa grupo si Attorney Anthony Abad. So maybe Attorney Garbin now can confirm.
Madam Chair, Attorney, former representative, if I'm not mistaken, Garbin.
I confirm the statement made by Attorney Abisado that Attorney Abad was one of those who started the Push for People's Initiative. Kasama po ako.
So, and Attorney Abad, Attorney Garbin, and the other resource persons from PIRMA, sila po ay kinontrata professionally to be the name on the list of the four, or to be the name on the forms distributed to collect signatures.
Wala hong kontrata. These are all voluntary. Since this is a national movement that composed of so many sectors of our society, including NGOs and POs, ito voluntary ho. Wala hong kontrata.
So, Attorney Garbin, could you confirm to the committee that Attorney Abad will be present in the next hearing?
The moment he arrives from our country, I think he's very much willing to face this committee.
Thank you, Attorney Garbin. Madam Chair, we have the assurance of Attorney Garbin and I believe the other resource persons from PIRMA that Attorney Abad will be present in this committee's next hearing. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Yes, thank you very much. Is there anyone? Yes, Minority
Can
Leader,
we...
please.
Can we now fix the identity of Attorney Anthony A. Abad? Can we show the picture to Mr. Oñate, Attorney Abisado, if we're really talking about the same person, at Attorney Garbin? So Attorney Abad of the Harvard Association yata, I think that's. Siya yung sinususpetsahan nating Attorney Anthony Abad, so we want a confirmation if he... Patingin nga muna...
Screen,
yes, okay. Can we put on screen? Para lang, tapos na, alam na natin. We now know who we are talking about.
Alam ba ninyo kung kailan ang balik? Any idea po, Attorney Garbin, Pido?
I was not apprised of his return in the country, but I was told that he's really out of the country. Yeah.
Is this the same fellow?
Okay.
Ayan na po. Ayan na po, sir.
Are we talking about the same?
Yes, Your Honor.
Si Tony Abad yan, yung dating USEC DTI.
Okay. Okay.
Oo, sige. At least nagkakaliwanagan
okay,
kasi...
Okay, no, no. Now we know the identity. And I'd just like to make off record my position, my interpretation, Madam Chair, that per the signatories, if these are really real signatures and a real people's initiative, only Attorney Anthony A. Abad can file the petition on their behalf. Siya lang. Siya. Only this,
that is
only
not
this
true,
one.
Your Honor, because...
That is my position. I want
that
to make
is your position.
Record.
From the very start, we were all together campaigning nationwide for this noble intention to amend the Constitution.
Because there
so,
was
in fact, in Albay, I was the one who spearheaded...
Well, Madam Chair, can we make order on this hearing?
Yes, Attorney Garbin, please allow the minority leader who
sorry,
has
I'm
the floor to complete his statement.
I'm chewing some Cheding's peanuts. Okay. Stop. Okay, the people... If this is a real people's initiative, made an effort to identify who can file the petition for them. They said, Attorney Anthony A. Abad, comma, et al. So the people identified one person. The et al, they made a mistake. Because they need to identify who can file the petition for them. Hence, their correct step was naming one person, and this is that person. So... Only Attorney Anthony A. Abad can file that petition on behalf of the people. Should COMELEC ever, pero iba na po, may ruling naman ng COMELEC that the present law and the present resolution is insufficient to entertain a petition. But should we come to that stage, only this person can file that petition. That's my position, Madam Chair. So opinion lang naman po yan, apa.
Yes, thank you very much, Minority Leader. Hindi po yung et al, kundi yung mismong pangalan ng Attorney Abad ang sinasabi po ninyo. Yes, Attorney Garbin, you had something to add.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. As to the Madam Chair, as to the position of the respected Senator, I beg to differ, Madam Chair. Normally, the movement is composed of several sectors of our society. A national movement wherein not only PIRMA, not only Attorney Abad, as mentioned by Congressman Marcoleta kanina, paano niya tatrabahuin ni Attorney Abad yung pag-disseminate at pag-distribute ng lahat ng forms to be signed by all registered voters kung nag-iisa lang siya. And therefore, nilagay na lang namin doon, when we start this movement, we start with Attorney Abad et al. At kasama ho si Noel Oñate doon, kasama ho si Justice
okay.
Biloso,
okay.
The former member, and kasama rin ho si Congressman Argel Kabatbat.
Okay. Yeah,
Madam Chair.
Maraming salamat. Yes, Senator Bato.
May ask from Attorney Garbin, is he confirming that since hindi kaya ni Attorney Abad na ubikot sa buong Pilipinas, that is why... He solicited the services of the chief of staff, the staff of the different congressmen all over the Philippines.
I cannot affirm your statement, Senator Bato, but when we enter each legislative district, there is some sort of tolerance from the members of Congress. I'm not saying that they did not directly participate in...
Senator Bato, kung papayagan ninyo, nalilito ako eh, magpa-follow up lang ako kay Senator Coco. Ang nakasulat lang, Attorney Abad, wala naman nakasulat doon pirma. Wala naman nakasulat doon. Ang sinabi lang, et al. Maloy namin kung sino si et al.
And that's why po, from the very start...
Maloy ng tao kung sino si et al. Papapirmahin ninyo, sino si et al.
From the very start ho, in fact, there's so many publications of which I was quoted that I am one of the petitioner in this People's Initiative. In fact, in Albay, when I was invited by the Mayor's League or the Liga ng mga Municipality of Albay, I confirmed there that not only did I advocating this movement, but I am also one of the petitioner in this People's Initiative. And that was all documented. Madam Sir.
Okay, be that as it may. Yes. Yes, I think Senator Cheese is going to make the same comment we all are. Yes, Senator Cheese.
On the topic, Madam Chair, with the permission of Senator Pimentel, since we're on this resource person, Mr. Oñate, when did you meet Congressman Garbin?
Okay, sir. When did you meet now?
When did you meet Congressman Garbin?
I met Congressman Garbin about a month ago.
A month ago?
Yes.
So prior to a month ago, you never thought of PI? Because
no,
he was the one spearheading it, according to him.
No, we launched PIRMA in 1996.
No, this particular initiative.
We've been talking about it in some parties, okay. In some gatherings.
Well, it's okay to talk about it, but in terms of initiating, you only met Congressman Garbin a month ago. You said?
Yeah, about a month ago, yes.
So I guess it was only a month ago that you also discussed this current initiative, because he's, based on his comments earlier, he's very active in this. So did he simply join you afterwards? You were already starting it, or a month ago after you met,
we started it January 2.
You started it January 2?
January 2,
so
yes.
Prior to meeting Congressman Garbin a month ago, you were not doing anything yet?
We were, but it was talking about it, and I told them about my experience. That
so,
I launched it before and all that.
Sino po ang naghingi ng meeting nung nag-meet kayo? Siya po nanghingi ng meeting o kayo po nanghingi ng meeting?
No, this was several parties, several dinners, and some...
So you met socially?
I volunteered the information that I know something about People's Initiative because we tried it before.
And you volunteered that information because he said he was interested in pursuing
it. And then I said, we can try it again because it's been my advocacy for the past 28 years, and why not?
When was this party, sir, and where was the place that you met and discussed that, and then you finally...
This was several parties, several...
San po?
Ibang lugar eh. Ibang lugar. Mm.
Kasama po ba sa lugar na yon ang kongreso o ang bahay ng speaker?
Hindi naman. Pero you know, I know a lot of people in the political circles, in the social circles, in the business circles.
Hindi po yun ang tinatanong ko.
Senator Cheese, if you will allow, in the news article sa PhilStar, Mr. Oñate admitted that the conveners of the People's Initiative coordinated with congressmen. Anong ibig sabihin ng coordinate? Sino ba ang pasimuno o kayo?
Yeah.
I'm a little bit confused. You're now saying January 2, but earlier you said it was Attorney Garbin who called you. Sino ba tumawag kanino?
Ako po ang nakipag-coordinate sa mga congressmen because according to the law, we are supposed to get 3% per congressional district.
Yes, we're
so
more
interested. So dahil 3% per congressional district, yung distrito na yon, eh, a congressman ang leader doon sa Congreso.
So who? Who are these congressmen? Senator Cheese and I would like to know who are the congressmen that your group coordinated with? Tinawagan ninyo o sila tumawag?
Ako ang nakipag-coordinate.
Oh, Senator Cheese.
Madam Chair, so under oath you admit that you coordinated this PIRMA initiative with congressmen since the 3% is required to be obtained per district.
Yeah, per district, yeah. That is so the requirement.
Sino? Sino naman kami ng pangalan? Ay, sorry, Chief. Go ahead.
So, tamang strategy naman yun. Sasangayin naman ako. Kuha ko ho yun nasa kalagayan ninyo, per district nga naman, ko-coordinate ko talaga sa congressman po yan dahil para makuha yung 3%. So, let me digress a bit, Madam Chair. Because kababayan ko itong si Attorney, that's why I refer to him as Congressman Garbin because he used to be a party list representative of the party list ako Bicol, which happens to be the same party list of the Distinguished Appropriations Chairman of the House of Representatives. And in your various Facebook posts, I see you often in the House, Congressman Garbin. I presume you are a consultant of Congressman Chairman Apro Chair Zaldico?
I serve as the Executive Director of Ako Bicol Party List. So I work with Ako Bicol until now.
But I see your pictures in most of the meetings in the House, Congressman Garbin, with the Speaker, not only as Ako Bicol Chairman. Which I...
That is true. That
pinapalo ka sige ito sa Facebook eh.
That is of public knowledge. Mm-hmm. That you can browse my Facebook talagang puno ng pictures ng House dahil nagtatrabaho po ako sa Ako Bicol Party List. Which happens to be ang isang representante ay chairman ng Committee on Appropriation.
Just to settle that fact, Madam Chair. Now, proceeding with the question of the chairperson. Mr. Oñate, you said you contacted congressmen to get the 3% per district. Nasabi ko nga, kung ako din yung nasa kalagayan yung sinusulong to, kukontakin ko rin yung congressman dahil per district ang usapan, di naman per barangay eh. Di ba? Per district ang usapan, di naman per munisipyo eh.
Yeah,
so, papunta dun sa tanong ni Senator Aimee, Chairman Aimee, sino po yung mga congressman na kinontak po ninyo na umuopo sa inyo, natutulungan kayo na makuha yung 3%?
Kaya naman namin naisip na lumapit sa mga congressmen is...
Yung mga pangalan na lang po, please. Marami po pa tayong testigo. Si nandito na
congressman
si Justice Rufus Carpio.
Rodriguez, at kinausap namin si
tayo.
Congressman Garbin, kinausap ko.
Sino ba po? Sino ba po?
Sina Congressman Zaldico kasama at si Speaker Romualdez?
Zaldico, no, I didn't talk to Zaldico.
Ganun po ba? Sigurado po kayo kasi marami-rami ang meeting ninyo, mga party, dinner. Sabi nga ninyo, ilang beses kayo. Sigurado kayo wala si Speaker, wala si Congressman Zaldico sa anumang pagtitipon?
Madam Chair, in all the meetings that transpired, none of the presence of Congressman Zaldico and Speaker Maldes was there. They were not there. Ako naman, nilapitan ni Mr. Oñate because he knew for a fact that in the 18th Congress, I was the chair of the Committee on Constitutional Amendments who defended the resolution of both houses number 2 passed the restrictive economic provisions of the Constitution.
With due respect to Congressman Garbin, may we just recognize the chairperson because they're flashing a very important picture on screen.
I received this photo, and I believe it was one of the meetings that you alleged, Mr. Oñate. Can you identify the people in the photograph?
Why can't they show the photo?
Yeah, we're trying to enlarge the picture to share it with everyone in the room. There we go. I think that's as big as we can get it. People's Initiative for Charter Change staff meeting, January 8. Can you tell us who are in the picture, Mr. Oñate, please?
Madam Senator.
The question is who, sir?
But you said you never had any meeting.
That I coordinated with the speaker.
You said you never met the speaker, nor Mr. Saldico, our congressman. You're under oath, sir.
Yes, that was the time that I met with the speaker.
Sasabi mo lang na hindi naman kayo nagkita. Sabi niyo sina Congressman Garvin lang.
Yeah, because you know, it slipped my mind. It slipped my mind, Madam Senator. That was the
okay
time
lang,
that
okay
I,
lang.
That,
kung nakalimutan ninyo bigla,
I sought the help
speaker
of the speaker
Martin Romualdez supporting your group.
To help us in the signature campaign, yes.
Okay, so it's very clear that Speaker Martin Romualdez is supporting your group po. He is all out behind the People's Initiative. Is that correct?
Yes, we coordinate with the speaker and the
Thank
congressman
much,
in getting the
3%
per
to...
congressional district. That's correct, Madam Senator.
Thank you very much for... helping us along with this investigation. I'd like to turn it back to Senator Cheese.
I'll wind up, Madam Chair. That was the point I wanted to establish, Madam Chair, distinguished colleagues, na maliban dun sa mga kongresistang binanggit nyo, baka na, kung si Speaker Romualdez nakalimutan yung banggitin, siguro mas marami pa kayong ibang nakalimutang banggitin. So, sa pagkakaalala nyo, kesa magpakita pa ho kami ng ibang litrato, sino pa pong mga kongresista ang nakausap nyo para makakuha ng pirma sa kada distrito?
As I have said earlier...
With the permission, Madam Chair, of... With the permission of Congressman Garvin, the question is being addressed to Mr. Oñate. Since he is the lead convener here and merely asked for the help of Congressman...
He's not the lead convener, Madam Chair, for the record.
I'm confused.
For pirma. But there's a different movement.
So pirma is no longer the lead convener.
No. Pirma is just one of the of the movement that
diba
goes around.
Magkasundo kayo? Kasi iba-iba yung sinasabi ninyo, nalilito po kami eh.
Just to be clear, Madam Chair, pirma is just one of the movement that goes around the country to gather signatures for this people's initiative. In the Bicol region, I may say that I'm the one leading and collecting signatures,
okay.
Making it for the Bicolanos understand what they've signed for.
Salamat po. Ibalik natin kay Mr. Oñate po.
Yes, if I may go back to Mr. Oñate, because Congressman Garvin, kasama ka lang sa et al. Ang nakasulat sa petitioner, si Attorney Abad, na inamin ni Mr. Oñate na isa daw sa mga conveners nila ng pirma. Di po ba? So, is Attorney Abad part of Ako Bicol or the new organization you put up, or is he part of PIRMA?
Not part of Ako Bicol, not part of PIRMA, but when he started independently as an advocate of this People's Initiative.
Kaangkin lang po ni Mr. Oñate na bahagi si Attorney Abad ng PIRMA.
Yes.
Sinabi niyo po kanina. Hanggang ngayon po, sinasabi niyo.
He is part of PIRMA. So, the only thing is, I think the lawyers forgot, is because the first batch of the forms that were printed, the name of Attorney Abad was used. But the subsequent forms are now PIRMA.
Okay.
Because the first batch was Anthony Abad.
Okay, ngayon, matanong ko po kayo. So kayo yung nagpa-print ng form na Attorney Abad? Yes or no?
I didn't have a hand in the printing of the forms.
No?
No.
So no. Okay.
Kayo po ba yung nagpa-print ng form na may pirma na nakalagay? Wala ng Attorney Abad?
Yes.
Kayo po yung nagpa-print?
Yeah, the subsequent forms
yes.
That were printed, pirma na.
Pirma na po. Ilan po
yung mga naunang form, Anthony Abad.
Sino po yung nagpa-print nun? E convener niyo po si Attorney Abad?
mga volunteers po.
Mga volunteers
mga
po.
Mga volunteers ang nagpa-print.
Eh yung pirma mismo na nakalagay kayo na nagpa-print.
Oh, yung law firm sila.
Magkano po ginastos niyo sa pagpapa-print ng form na may pirma?
I don't have the exact figures right now. Let me consult with
please ask him. Yeah, I'm sure they should know. You knew this was going to be discussed.
Well, what I know is that the figure that I know, I don't know the figure regarding the printing of the forms. But the figure that I know is the airing of the advertisement. That's the figure that I know.
Pupunta po tayo doon. Dumuna tayo sa, mas mahal po yun eh.
The advertisement cost 55 million. We ABS-CBN, TV5, and GMA7.
Yes, if Senator Cheese will allow, sorry.
I don't have the figures.
So although you printed the forms with the pirma at the bottom, you have no clue how much it cost.
No.
This is remarkable. Because
it's the staff that knows. Because I don't know everything.
With the permission of Senator Cheese, there's a quick manifestation from Senator Bato here.
Yeah, thank you, Madam Chair. Mr. Oñate, I just would like to remind you na sana ba remind lang kita baka sunod-sunod yung pagsisinungaling mo ba? Ha? Una, alam mo under oath ka. Tapos sinabi mo kanina you never had a meeting with the speaker kung sino-sino mang nasa likuran nito. Ngayon when we show you the picture, sabi mo it slips your mind. Kaya I'm just giving you a fair warning, ha? Fair warning. Please, do not lie before this committee. Please, do not lie before this committee, ha? Magpakatotoo tayo dito.
Ha? No, because I was asking my lawyers, sino yung pwede kong banggitin, and sinabi nila, si Rufus Rodriguez and Congressman Harbin.
Kaya nga, but sabi mo kanina, tinanong ka ng chairman.
Speaker Mualdez, and I didn't say that.
Hindi kasama sa meeting pero nandiyan may picture.
In fact, if you check my interviews with the various radio stations, I mentioned to them that I went to Speaker Romualdez to seek his assistance regarding People's Initiative.
Madam Chair,
thank you for that clarification.
I admitted in various interviews.
Madam Chair, I saw your interviews actually, Mr. Oñate, and you were very vocal and honest about the fact that you sought the Speaker's assistance. Now, may I ask, what kind of assistance did he give you?
Administrative and advisory.
Because
being the Speaker, he is like the CEO.
Of the House?
Of Congress, yes.
So ano po yung administrative na tulong na binigay niya sa'yo para makalap yung 3% per district?
Yung mga tao namin, pupunta sa isang distrito, makikipag-coordinate sila sa congressman because it's the congressman who is in turn the CEO of the district. Kasi distrito niya yun eh. So natural lamang
kaya sinasabi ninyo,
na pupuntahan
sa madaling
namin yung congressman.
So, hindi talaga kaya ng pirma isa-isahin ang mga distrito. Ang nakatutok, si Speaker, inuutusan yung mga congressman. Tama?
Hindi naman po. Kami po ang pumupunta sa mga congressman.
Pagsasabihan ko lang si Atty. Abisado na huwag mag-coach, please. Anong sabi po ninyo? Hindi ninyo kaya, di ba, sa pirma? Kasi napakaraming distrito. So, nagpatulong kayo at sila yung nakatutok.
There are 250 districts, 257
districts. Inaamin ninyo na ang nakatutok, yung kongresista at si Speaker, tama po ba?
Tinutulungan kami ng kongresista dahil distrito po niya yung
Apo. Madam Chair.
Anong uri ng tulong?
Congressional district. Madam Chair, can I be recognized, Madam Chair?
No, let us finish, please. Yes, it's our hearing. Thank you. Back to Mr. Oñate po. Anong tulong ang binibigay ng mga kongresista at ni Speaker?
Ang tulong nila, kung ano yung population ng distrito nila, kung saan po...
makukuha naman yun online po.
Kung saan kukuha ng mga boto, tinuturo nila, yun, basically administrative ang tulong nila.
If I may, hindi nyo naman kilala yung mahigit 250 kongresista, so kailangan talaga na makapagbigay ng administrative na tulong ang speaker na masabihan yung mga congressman na pag nagpunta yung tao nyo doon o kayo, asikasuhin.
Opo. Inamin ko naman po sa mga radio stations at sa mga interview sa TV and all that. In fact, there are days that I'm being interviewed 3 times, 4 times a day. And grabe kung makatawag ang
I've seen most of the interviews, sir. I've seen most of the interviews.
10 beses, no? Walang tigil. Kaya pag-coordinate ako kay speaker, natulungan naman kami sa aming pagpapapirma sa mga distrito.
Kasama po ba sa administrative?
Kasi sumusunod lang po kami sa batas. Sinasabi po ng batas na pumunta kami sa congressional district at kumuha ng 3% per congressional district.
Kasama po ba sa tulong yung pagsang-ayon doon sa timetable na nakita at pinalabas na rin sa media na may timetable na sa gantong petsa dapat na-submit na, sa gantong petsa dapat na-file nyo na, sa gantong petsa dapat i-verify, sa gantong petsa dapat plebisito na. Ang sinasabi na ilang mambabatas ay June, July daw dapat ang target. Tama po ba yan? Kasama yun sa napag-usapan at napagkasundoan.
Meron target, pero hindi naman absolute yung target na yun. Ako nga po, sinasabi ko, kung hindi kaya ng June, July, baka September, October.
Ang tanong
kasi
ko po...
Hindi ko rin alam eksakto kung kailan matatapos. Pero, a few months. Kaya sinabi ko din na... Kasi yan din ang tanong ng mga nag-i-interview. Sabi ko, mga 2 to 3 months because I don't have the exact timetable also.
So yung pag-set po ng timetable na yon kasama o factored in na yung administrative na assistance ni Speaker at ng ilang mga mambabatas para maitalaga yung dates na ma-meet hanggat kaya?
Yeah, more or less, we have a timetable but the timetable is not on exact dates.
And this timetable was agreed upon...
2 to 3 months, 2 to 3 weeks.
And this timetable was agreed upon or at least discussed in that meeting? This timetable was agreed upon or at least discussed in this meeting when you asked for his assistance?
Wala namang timetable na eksakto, parang...
Period, may range.
Estimate.
Opo, yung estimate na timetable na pag-usapan at napag-agrihan sa pulong na ito, o isa na to sa mga pulong na napag-usapan yon.
Yes, more or less po.
Ngayon, maliban sa administrative na tulong, ano pa po ang binigay na tulong ng tanggapan ng speaker?
Wala na po.
Dalawa po yung binanggit nyo kanina. May I appeal to the records?
An advisory.
Ano pong advisory ang binigay sa inyo?
Ina-advise kami kung saan maraming mga tao na pipirma, kung saan. Basically, ang tinuturo nila yung C and D sector ng mga voters.
Bakit daw po?
They tell us to concentrate on the C and D kasi sila ang nakakarami. We were told that 75 to 80% of our voters belong to the C and D market. So doon kami nagpupunta.
Sino po nagsabi sa inyo?
Yung mga congressmen po.
Maliban...
Alam nila kung saan madaming mga butante.
Kung saan madami para mas madaling puntahan.
Yeah. Parang kunyari, let's say you're going to a supermarket and then you want to buy something. Mm. Of course, you're gonna ask the supervisor of the supermarket where I can buy this stuff. Or ganun din po ang ginawa namin. Pagpunta sa distrito, tinatanong namin sa distrito, sa congressman, CEO ng distrito, kung saan kami pupunta at makakuha ng madaming pirma.
Last 2 points, Madam Chair, if you will bear with me. So, yung tagumpay ninyo thus far, na nakakuha na kayo na mahigit 3% sa mahigit 200 distrito, hindi nyo po magagawa ito ng kayo lamang kung wala ang tulong o administrative support, advice ng mga kongresista.
Malaking tulong po ang nagbibigay ng mga kongresista sa pag-identify kung saan kami kukuha ng mga ng mga signatures.
At kung wala nga po yun, mahihirapan tulad ng mga nakaraang karanasan ninyo.
Magagawa naman po, pero medyo matatagalan.
Hindi kasing bilis tulad ngayon. Hindi kasing bilis tulad ngayon. Sabi niyo magagawa naman, pero kung wala ang tulong ng kongresista, hindi kasing bilis tulad ngayon.
Oo, mas mabilis kung may tulong ng kongresista kung na pinpointing to us where to get the signatures.
Ngayon, isang tanong na lamang po, yung 55 million na ginastos niyo para sa EDSA Puera ad, saan po galing yun?
Ako po ang nag-provide noon, binigay ko yung cash kay Mr. Greg Garcia. Mm. Yung aming PR, siya yung aming
si Greg
PR.
Pa gumawa noon?
Oo.
Saan po galing yung 55 million?
Pera ko po yun. Contribution sa akin ng mga kaibigan, mga supporters namin.
So mga $1 million po yun, di ba?
More or less po, opo.
So personal, magkano po sa 55 million ang pera ninyong personal?
Mga kalahati po nun.
So mga 26?
More or less.
Sorry, mali.
More or less. 55, mga 27.5.
Sorry, polisay lang po ako. Hindi ako math major tulad ni Senator Pimentel. Yung kalahati, saan galing yung bulto? Ano yung pinakamalaking contribution?
Yung bulto nga po, ako po ang nagpondo nun.
Yung kalahati na nga po?
Yung kalahati, maraming mga contributors.
Mga tigma magkano po?
May mga nagbigay ng 1 million, may nagbigay ng 500,000, may nagbigay ng 2 million.
Pwede niyo po bang banggitin kung sino yung mga nagbigay ng million?
I don't recall right now.
Pero pwede ninyong handa naman yung committee tanggapin pag nabigay ninyo yung record.
Can my lawyer be the one to answer that?
Who is your lawyer, by the way? Is Attorney Abisado, who seems to be coaching you here as your counsel or as a resource person?
Madam Chair, I really apologize. Please, because Mr. Noel Oñate has difficulty of hearing. That's why I keep on repeating what the good Senator Escudero has been asking.
Thank you, sir. So
I just really, Your Honor, I do not coach. I'm really sorry.
So may we know that the million peso contributors?
Anong gagawin?
Yung 1 million and above lang.
I have to ask them if I can give their names.
Sige, dahil ang problema dyan, di ba may donor's tax din dyan, Senator Cheese?
Yan yung math major, oh.
Oh, di. Nagbayad ba sila ng donor's tax?
I can compute the amount because that's math, pero ang tanong legal, eh.
Yeah, no, kindly.
There should be, my opinion, Madam Chair, there should be.
Kindly inquire, sir, if they consent.
6%.
And we will also research if we can compel. The reason why perhaps the committee can compel disclosure is because, you know, public interest demands accountability and transparency. Hindi ito isang bagay na kinakahiya. Tulad nga ng sinabi ni Congressman Garbin kanina, noon pa niya paborito, noon pa niya gusto to. Chairman pa lang siya ng Consti Amendments. And in fact, it's the first time that I thought Congressman Garbin was one of your lawyers, but apparently he's one of the conveners. But it's the first time that I saw him. So, this matter of PI, if you really believe in it, it's not something that you should be ashamed or embarrassed about. The same is true with your donors. And on the part of the public, on our part, well, accountability and transparency dictate that we should know who are the people behind it. Let me give you some advice, Mr. Oñate, if you really believe in charter change. For me, I may be wrong. The main reason why PIRMA has failed in its past attempts, and probably even this one, is because people don't trust those who are supposedly behind it because they're always hiding behind someone else. So it's an opportunity for your donors as well to come out and be proud of that. I will not fault them for believing in something that I disagree with, for example. In fact, I will respect them for coming out in the open. Kumbaga, kung ayaw nilang lumabas, wala silang pinagkaiba doon sa mga nakatestigo kanina naka-masker at naka-shades. Hindi naman po siguro ganun yun. Wala naman silang inaakusan na krimen na ginawa. This is something I believe that they should stand up and be counted for. Thank you, Madam Chair. Thank you, Mr. Oñate. I hope you will talk to your donors.
The bulk of the money came from me. So,
we take note of that, sir.
The bulk of the money came from me.
Thank you.
Madam Chair. For the record. Again,
Madam Chair, can I answer? Being one of the petitioner of this.
I'm sorry. I think we have many resource persons led by Justice Carpio, Justice Ascuna, and the rest who will respond to that query later on. May I proceed with Mr. Oñate?
Madam Chair.
Yes, Senator.
At any rate, pwede naman mag-position paper or memorandum
yes,
sila, Attorney Garbin.
We will welcome your position paper, Attorney Garbin.
Madam Chair, just
but
to,
just on the point
to,
of there's no enabling
you,
law.
He's not being recognized.
This is a matter of debate, and we simply have no time at this hearing.
There's a developing consensus over here, Madam Chair, that we can compel our resource person, Mr. Oñate, to divulge the names of his donors. At 12:30 p.m. pa lang naman, hindi pa naman tayo patapos, he can call his office to get the names. The names must be divulged to this committee this afternoon before we end. Dapat ganun. Kasi tama, narinig namin yung kay Senator Chis, and I hope Mr. Oñate agrees with Senator Chis. Public, ganun to eh, public issues. Public issues, wag mahiya yung nag-donate.
Mr. Senator, I already disclosed or already admitted that the bulk of the money came from me.
Pero kalahati so,
you have a partial compliance. We need full compliance. So,
yung mga ibang amount naman, maliliit na.
Di bali po, ako na po magsusuma total doon. Sige po, yung 27.5 million ang ating account po. Sige po. So, what do we do with that matter, Madam Chair? I think we should compel the...
we therefore compel Mr. Oñate to produce the said documents at the soonest possible time. Yes, Attorney Avisado, please.
You have to give me time to talk to them kasi ako naman lang mapapahiya sa mga, kung banggitin ko yung mga pangalan nila, you know,
Kasasabi lang po ng minority leader before 2 p.m. sana this afternoon, magsesesyon pa kami eh. At saka madali naman yun eh.
Madam Chair,
may
I be allowed to ask a few questions to Mr. Oñate?
I'm sorry, Congressman. I think our rules don't allow resource persons to interpellate po. Okay lang. Okay. But everyone agrees to suspend in your case.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Mr. Oñate, alam po ninyo yung kahalagahan ng initiative na ito at kakailangan ninyo ang maraming resources dito. Hindi po biro-biro ito, tama po?
Yes, I agree.
Yung pagpapapirma lamang po, Mr. Oñate, kakailangan ninyo ang hindi kukulangin ng 8 milyon para ma-address nyo yung threshold na 12% ng ating total registered voters, hindi po ba?
12% of our total number of voters is about 8 million.
Oo nga po. Ngayon, meron po tayong about 257 legislative districts. Alam po ninyo yun. Kailangan po ninyong masatisfy yung second threshold na 3%. Kaya napilitan kayo, ayaw nyo man siguro, na magpatulong na kayo sa mga representatives ng kanikanyang distrito. Tama po ba yun?
Yes, that's correct.
Sapagkat nagiging practical kayo siguro, sapagkat sa inyo lang, siguro kahit na yung et al na ito, ilan po ba kayo? Kahit na siguro 100 kayo, mahihirapan pa rin kayo na pumunta sa iba't ibang dako ng ating kapulungan para magpapirma lang kayo, lalo na kung ipaliliwanag pa ninyo, sapagkat hindi pipirma ang tao kapag hindi nila ganap na naunawaan kung ano ang kanilang pinipirmahan. Yung bahagi ng pagpunta sa kanila, pagpapaliwanag, yun po yung malaking panahon na kakailanganin ninyo. Kaya naisipan ninyong pumunta siguro sa mga miyembro ng House of Representatives. Tama po, Mr. Oñate?
Tama po.
Pero nakalimutan mo akong puntahan, di ba?
Yeah, okay. Kasi hindi ko...
Oh, ngayon, dahil wala akong
hindi
district.
Hindi ko po kayo kasi...
Ngayon, ganito po. Mr. Oñate, meron po ba kayong nalalaman na batas na pinagbabawal po yung ginawa ninyo na makipag-ugnayan sa mga kongresista?
Wala naman po. Alang, kasi yung People's Initiative is enshrined in our Constitution and it is the right of the people to
so wala
make that
pong,
initiative. Yun po ang sabi sa akin ng mga lawyer.
So wala pong batas na nagbabawal sa inyo, lalong-lalo na po kung kayo nagpapatulong dahil sa paniwala ninyo, ito ay isang bagay na kinakailangan ninyong gawin. So lumapit po kayo, napaniwala ninyo na wala namang batas na nagbabawal nito at hindi po kayo makukulong. Tama po?
Tama po.
Salamat po, Madam Chair.
Thank you for all the leading questions.
Madam.
Maraming salamat sa ating kongresista. Napakagaling na abogado para kay Mr. Oñate.
Madam Opa. Chair.
Gusto ko lang balikan yung ating retrato na nandito sa harap natin. Galing po ito sa cellphone ninyo, January 8. Tama po ba, Mr. Oñate?
Oo, tama.
And that's in fact you in the picture, that's correct?
You confirm that it's you.
You confirm that this is you in the picture?
Yes.
And you also confirm that it's Speaker Romualdez in the picture?
Yes.
And it is Congressman Saldi Co in the picture?
Yes, yeah.
Can you read the caption, please? Yung caption sa ilalim po. May nakasulat,
yes,
diba?
That's correct. Tama po ba? Tama po.
At maliban sa pagkain, klaro na may mga dokumento sa table. Meeting po to, hindi lang party. Anong pinag-usapan?
Meeting po yan kung paano kami makikipag-coordinate sa mga congressmen.
Saan lugar to? Saan ginanap itong parting to? Para lang malaman namin.
Sa ano po yan? Sa townhouse sa Forbes. Sa Forbes Park.
Kanino nga? Kaninong lugar? Ipaliwanag. Wala namang masama magtipon-tipon sa bahay ng Miss Kishino.
Dalawang townhouse.
Hindi, kanino na, po? Kaninong lugar? Inyo? Bahay mo? Bahay mo po?
It's a meeting
Attorney
place.
Abisado,
it's our,
please.
It's our meeting place.
No, pero sino may-ari?
Sino may-ari
ng bahay?
Si Speaker Romualdez po.
Bahay ni Speaker Romualdez.
Yes.
Ah, ganon. So, ang naging host
po,
at nagkumbida... ay si Speaker Romualdez. Tama
ako
po ba?
Ako po ang nagkumbida. Dapat
paano ka
sa...
magkukumbida? Di mo bahay.
Oo nga. Oo nga po. Dapat po yan sa bahay ko. Dahil meron po akong party house sa Dasma. Walang tao doon.
Pero hindi ba maliwanag
pero
na kung bahay ni Speaker...
Ang sabi ng staff, doon na lang gawin sa bahay ni Speaker. Dalawang bahay ni Speaker eh. Isa sa
okay.
McKinley... At isa,
hindi ba at maliwanag?
Sa,
hindi ba maliwanag kung bahay ni Speaker siya nagpatawag ng meeting edi talagang nakikialam si Speaker sa People's Initiative?
Ako po ang nag-initiate ng meeting. Pero sinabi po na doon na lang gawin sa townhouse ni Speaker. But ako po ang nag-initiate.
Ay,
dapat
ganon.
Po sa bahay ko pero sinabihan ako na doon na lang pumunta.
Sino nagdala ng papeles kasi bahay niya? Ikaw nagdala ng papel?
Mga lawyer po. Sila,
yung mga
sila,
lawyer.
Mga lawyer po, dala,
so,
dala
bahagi
mga
ka talaga ng Project PI. Yung Project PI na tinetext sa mga kongresista, pati ako nga na-text kasi luma na yung number ko eh. Bahagi kayo ng Project PI?
Yeah. Kasi I thought, the help of the speaker, inamin ko naman po,
you've said that
natulungan
before.
Kami okay. Dito sa signature gathering.
Right. Okay, kilala ninyo itong sina Attorney Redentor Tuason?
I don't know.
Suset Sumalinog, Timothy Lagundi. Kilala ninyo itong mga to?
Hindi po.
Okay. Kasi meron kaming mga screenshot doon sa Project PI na galing sa mga congressman. At sabi mo, nakikipag-coordinate ka kay Speaker na CEO at ng, sa mga ng, hawak ng, niyang Congress. Congressman.
Yeah, that's correct. That's correct, Madam Senator.
Okay. So,
Madam Chair?
Yes, Senator Bato, please. Ayan yung mga screenshot. Kasi sabi mo, bahagi ka ng Project PI. Nagtatanong lang ako, baka kilala mo itong mga to. Andito, oh, yung mga pangalan.
Hindi ko kilala.
Anong pagkaintindi mo dyan sa message na yan? Pakibasa lang po.
I don't know all of the details because, you know,
De, lahat ng kongresista pinapasubmit, ano, sa National Secretariat Attorney Red Tuason. Ayun. Ayan ang hinihingi nila, yung mga kopya, at saka accomplished signature forms. Kasi sabi ninyo, may kinalaman kayo sa second batch ng signature forms, di po ba?
Yes.
So, isasubmit dito sa mga taong hindi ninyo kilala, samantalang kayo ang nagpa-imprenta? Senator Bato, please.
Madam Chair, gusto ko lang ipa-confirm kay Mr. Oñate, since sinabi niya kanina na he sought the help of the speaker para makakuha ng perma. So, pumayag siya. In fact, nag-meeting kayo, di ba?
Yes.
Pumayag siya. So, meaning, sinabi mo, perma ang nasa likuran nitong People's Initiative. Humingi kayo ng suporta galing kay Speaker Romualdez. Pinigyan kayo ng tulong, ng suporta, para tumakbo ng inyong People's Initiative. Ibig sabihin, si Speaker Romualdez, isa na rin sa nasa likod ng
pumayag naman po si Speaker.
Pumayag
si Speaker.
Nasa likuran na rin siya.
Natulungan kami kasi siya ang CEO ng Congress.
Kaya nga, gusto ko lang i-confirm sa'yo na siya rin ay kasama na, nasa likod na rin ang pagpatakbo ng PI. Dahil nga, tumulong siya sa inyo, di ba?
Yeah, he is helping us.
Thank you for that answer.
Madam Chair,
maraming salamat. So, kinukumpirma mo. Parang naguguluhan ako. Kinukumpirma na politician's initiative tulad ng sinabi ni Senator.
Hindi naman po. Tumutulong lang sila. Pero kami ang nasa forefront ng pagpapapirma. Oo. Palagay ko, wala namang masama na tumanggap ng tulong
okay
sa mga congressmen.
Senator JB Sige, oh, tama naman. Patulong kayo sa lahat ng tao, lalong-lalo na yung mga CEO ng malalaking kapulungan. Senator JV, please.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Curious ako, pwede tanungin si Mr. Oñate or the conveners of itong BI. Of all the provisions that can be amended under the Constitution, bakit napili ng pirma i-amendan yung provision on the manner of voting? Di ba? Kasi pagkakaalam ko, na kung meron kayong gustong amendahan sa konstitusyon, dapat ang tatanungin, either political or economic provisions, pero yung voting provisions or manner of voting, nakalagay doon, voting jointly. Bakit po yun? Gusto ko lang pong maliwanagan.
As one of the petitioner, Mr. Chair, Senator Ehers, ito, we specifically propose amendment to the manner of voting because this is the consistent roadblock that prevents the Republic of the Philippines, the Senate and the House to propose amendment to the Constitution. When I was the chair of the Committee on Constitutional Amendments, we passed the RBH2. Pinasa namin sa House of Representatives, 19th Congress. We transmitted the RBH2 to the Senate.
Di ba kung People's Initiative, pwede naman diretso sa economic provisions?
Para tama po, and that's why, let me...
Example, economic na kagad.
Yes po.
Bakit hindi economic ang
you cannot put one subject in a petition that's Republic Act 6735, of which you cannot put more than one subject in a petition. And that's why to erase that roadblock, which is a consistent roadblock in proposing this amendment to the Constitution, might as well that infirmity or ambiguity in the interpretation on how Congress will vote, sitting as constituent assembly, dapat ho maklarify. And that's why ito po yung pinakarason. Kasi kung ilalagay po natin yung Article 12, 14, and 16 of the 1987 Constitution, which speaks of the restrictive economic provisions of the Constitution, that would be inviolative of Republic Act 6735, that prescribe that there should be no more than one subject in a petition.
Madam Chair.
Alam rin namin yon ang ating SP.
Yes, Madam Chair. Let us go back to what, to the subject matter at hand.
Boss SP, because, may I just put on record because being the chair of the Committee on Rules, only RBH 6 of the House calling for a constitutional convention was actually transmitted by Congress to the Senate. The RBH 2 has not been transmitted. That's for the record.
Madam Chair, you might forget, the majority leader might forget that in the 18th Congress, June of 2021, and you were still a member of that Congress.
Are we going to talk about the other Congresses or even the history of Congress? In fact, Madam Chair, I was about to make mention about the statements made by Mr. Oñate. If this is indeed a people's initiative and not a political initiative, bakit nang gagaling lahat sa politiko? Bakit sila yung nagtatarget sino yung mag-i-initiate? Hindi ho ba klaro na ito ay politician's initiative? Just to point it out, Madam Chair.
Baka naman siguro, Madam Chair, I see you recognize me already. Baka hadlang ang Senado sa mga agenda ng ibang politiko. Di ba? Ganun lang naman yun eh. With due respect, Madam Chair, the point of order I see is that let's go back to the germane, what's germane to this topic, which is the signature buying, manipulation being done.
Thank you
is
very
it the,
much.
Through people's initiative or politicians' initiative. Let's go back to that. We will have our hearings on this issue on charter change where we can invite our distinguished friends, former congressmen and congressmen to those hearings, together with the justices, together with ex-justices, deans, and constitutionalists to debate on that issue. But at this point in time, let's go back to the main point of this hearing, which is we're trying to look for shenanigans, you know, in the part of getting and collecting these signatures.
Maraming salamat. Yes, and thank you very much for SP for establishing order. And indeed, it's a massive feat to conduct a Project PI requiring massive funds. And you said that you largely, Mr. Oñate, funded PIRMA, at least with the EDSA Puera commercial. And you also admitted that it was upwards of $55 million that you spent. Do you have the receipt?
I think so. I think we have a receipt.
Is it your office or your corporation or PIRMA as an NGO that paid for the ad?
Yeah, because I gave the money in cash to Mr. Greg Garcia, and he was the one that paid the advertising agency.
I'm a little bit confused. I was informed, but that in fact payment was made to Gana Atienza Avisado Law Office. Why was it necessary to go through the law office? Did you need an escrow or trust account?
I gave the cash to Greg Garcia, who is our PR, and I think Mr. Greg Garcia was the one that paid the ad agency. I don't know whether it was coursed to somebody else, but
in fact, it was cash. There was no receipt. There was no BIR, no donor's tax, no documentation. It was cold, hard cash. Is that correct?
Yeah, it is. It was. I gave it to him in cold cash because, well, that's how politics works.
I'm sorry, that's how politics operates, through cash?
I've also been a political consultant all these years, and I know how it works.
55 kilos of cash, sir. Hindi, ang sabi kasi binayaran through the law office. Naguguluhan ako because you said you handed over 55 million in cash to Mr. Greg Garcia, isang bulto. Paano pumasok yung ating mga abogado?
Madam Chair, if I may.
Yes, Attorney Abisado.
To explain our role in the TV ad, what happened was this was very early start of the year. And when Mr. Noel Oñate engaged the firm of Mr. Greg Garcia for the creative agency, Mr.
Teka,
Garcia...
Naguguluhan ako. At in the beginning of this year?
Yes po.
Eh, nag-umpisa to December pa eh.
Yes po. On the creative aspect po, last year pa. And then, payment should be made for the TV stations ASAP. But since PIRMA could not comply, wala ho kasing, marami ho kasing documentary requirements. So what we did, kami na as the law office, since we can comply with all the documentary requirements ng pag-post nitong TV ads, kami na po ang nag-submit.
But yung payment ho,
when we were sent the bill, we gave it to Mr. Oñate and sabi namin, sir, ito na ho yung billing ng ad agency, kayo na ho bahala magbayad. That's what happened po.
Asan ang resibo? Kanino ginawa yung resibo? Kay Mr. Oñate, sa PIRMA, o sa Abisado Law Office?
Ma'am, wala pa pong OR, pero meron ho yatang invoice. May invoice ho kami to the law office. Kasi kami yung lumalabas na advertiser. Having complied with all the documentary requirements.
So, ibibigay ninyo sa amin yung OR, walang resibo, at sekreto sa BIR kasi wala rin donor stocks?
Yes. Ma'am, wala pa po kaming OR but we have a billing invoice that we can submit.
Sige, titignan namin. So ano nangyari dun sa cash? Akala ko ang nagkaliwaan ay yung cash ni Mr. Oñate dun kay Mr. Garcia. Paano pumasok yung law office? Di ko pa rin maintindihan eh.
Kami lang po nag-represent kay Mr. Oñate in the
application. Bakit kailangan ng representation? May daladalang bultong ka.
That's a separate matter po.
Marami pa kaysa sa 55 million?
Hindi ma'am, when we told Madam Chair, Mr. Oñate, sir, ito ho yung bill. Kayo na ho bahala magbayad. Then he said, sige, ako nang bahala. And then yung invoice ho, sa amin ho pinadala. And we will comply. We will submit the invoice sent to our office, pero wala pa pong official receipt. And the amount that Mr. Oñate paid, kasama na po lahat yon, both the creative aspect of the ad and the TV placements for the three TV stations, TV5, ABS-CBN, and GMA7. Yun po. Thank you.
Pero ikaw ang nagsabi, baka pwede mong sabihin kung sino yung ibang donor. Pagkat ikaw yung nagpa-interview at sinabi nyo, ambag-ambag, tulong-tulong, Attorney Abisado, di ba sinabi mo yon? Na puro donations sa iba't ibang volunteer.
Yes, ma'am, I remember I told that. Yun din ho yung representation sa amin ni Mr. Oñate. And that is consistent with what he said earlier, that he paid the bulk of the TV ads, sarili niya pong pera. And the others, meron din ho yatang ambag-ambag.
Abogado ba kayo ng PIRMA o member, lead convener din?
Ma'am, hindi po. We are lawyers of Mr. Oñate. He has been our client many years before. And in fact, he is related by affinity to our managing partner, Attorney Aris Gana. Magkamag-anak po sila. So that explains the connection between our firm and Mr. Oñate.
What explains the connection of your firm to Speaker Romualdez? Andito po ang liwaliwanag ng Congress dito sa posting na ikaw ay isang consultant ng Office of the Speaker. Itong retratong to nasa labas ng Speaker's office.
Ma'am, Madam Chair, hindi po ako consultant. You can check all the records. I'm not a consultant. But I don't deny, I know the speaker. He is a fraternity brother of the fraternity brother in the Upsilon. And kami po, we go a long way. But ang client po namin dito, hindi po si speaker, kundi si Mr. Noel Oñate. That picture, hindi ho ako, that was one of those times na sumama ho kami, tumingin, pumunta lang ho dun sa Congress, kasama ho kasi yung isang associate ho namin na nandito. Pero ma'am...
Pero, so mali si Congressman JJ, kasi anong liwanag, oh, consultant to the Office of the Speaker.
Yes po, with all due respect to the good congressman, hindi po ako consultant ni Speaker, and the record will bear me out.
Di ba naging abogado ka rin ng tingog?
Ni-refer po ako ni Speaker kay... sa mga kamag-anak, kay Mayor Alfred Romagdas, who's been my client, and if you will admit, I am very proud of being one of your lawyers, Madam Chair.
Kaya nga alam ko na ang pagkaalam ko, consultant kay. Kaya nagtataka.
Hindi po. How I wish I was a consultant. Dagdag rin po yon, pero hindi po ako consultant.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Like to,
on that topic lang.
Yes po.
Bakit po nahirapan ang pirma for the documentary requirements? In 1990, organization pa po ang pirma. Eh. So, what's wrong with their documents?
Very good question, Senator Pimentel. Hindi ho kasi updated yung payments. In fact, to be honest, updated yung records nila. In fact, ngayon ho kami palang nag-update ng records kasi ho, yung mga stalwarts ng pirma, sino Mr. Pedrosa and the other kasama ni Mr. Oñate, wala na po ngayon. So, nag-aayos pa ho kami. And since kailangan ho namin mag-comply, kami na lang ho nag-step in.
So, kung ang TV stations ay pinagdududahan o hindi qualified ang papers ng pirma, baka pagdating na nito sa COMELEC, even yung exist judicial, juridical existence ng pirma, in doubt na rin po kasi even TV stations will not air an ad because of the questionable papers of PIRMA. So how much more amend the constitution through PIRMA? I mean, that's just just an opinion na kung ganyan na sa TV ads lang hindi na pasado papeles ng PIRMA, and then you will say we are the group behind this then we will file the petition sa COMELEC.
That is well noted, Mr. Good Senator. In fact, we agree with your sentiments. We respect your sentiments. Kami po sa PIRMA, for the record, we are against any form of vote buying, bribery, or aid in exchange for signatures because alam ho namin, napakahigpit ho ng COMELEC. They will invalidate all the signatures given a very slight evidence of bribery. So, sayang naman ho. Ang pinaghinapan ng mga volunteers ho at yung coordinators ng PIRMA. So, maingat din ho kami, sir.
When did you start soliciting signatures?
This year po, ang umpisa ho namin, Senator, is the information campaign which was started by that TV ad.
The signatures. Ito mga form na with signatures. December pa to umiikot na eh.
Yes po. Kami sa PIRMA this year po, pero yung grupo ni na Attorney Garbin, wala ho kasi kaming monopoly on people's initiative. Mm. Marami din ho kasing gumalaw. So maybe Attorney Garbin can also speak for his group.
PIRMA can tell this committee January...
Public information started with the, sir, with the TV ads, ad. Okay. And then after that, nag-gather na ho kami. What? Nauna si na Attorney Garbin.
PIRMA muna, PIRMA. Can you give me a date? When did you start soliciting signatures as PIRMA? Just a date. January 2, 2024. Si Attorney Garbin would be the attorney about the signature sheets. Yeah. Mga December pa po yan, tama?
No, on our part, first because batch. Ako, concerned lang po ako sa Bicol region. Nag-start po kami January 5, including the distribution of the forms, the signature sheets.
So yung mga Mindanao, hindi nyo na, wala na kayo yun?
Wala na po, Bicol region lang po ako.
Pero
Senator Coco, natanggap ko yung timeline at yung form, December 23.
Yes, December to sa Mindanao, ayan ang feedback na sa akin. Pero, so who will be the knowledgeable person to us, sa grupo po ninyo, about the national movement?
Yung movement po namin ay maraming convener.
Okay.
But for every region, may assigned. Ako po yung assigned sa Region 5. Sa Region 5. And I called four governors and the Liga ng mga barangays to facilitate.
If the committee is interested to know the movement sa Mindanao, who do we ask in your group?
Wala ho po akong alam.
Sino bang nakataas sa iyo as the regional coordinator of Bicol Region? Sino pang nakataas? Because yun ang pupunta.
Kami-kami ho yung nag-uusap. Kami ni na Attorney Abad kasama si Noel Oñate, Justice Biloso, former congressman, and Argel Kabatbat. Opo.
Okay. So lumalabas, Madam Chair, there may actually be two signature sheets na umiikot. Ibang wording nun. So kailangan conscious din po tayo ron. And once this is
just to add minority leader.
Let me finish, Attorney Garbin. Once this is formally to be presented, dadaan po sa microscope yung mga kada salita dun sa signature sheets na to, kasi magkaiba pala, hindi dalawang grupo. And is it possible that there is also a third group, more than two groups?
There are numerous groups. Okay. For this national movement.
Kanya-kanya sila sa signature campaign.
Tama
kanya.
Po.
Okay, so ganun pala. So it's not talagang i-examinein po lahat ito. Kanya-kanyang approach din sila, Madam
and
Chair.
And just to add, minority leader, Madam if Chair, I may finish.
Madam Chair, Attorney Garbin wants to be recognized.
Yes, that when we treat each signatory, we tell them that petitioner din po sila. Hindi lang po si Attorney Abad, hindi lang po ako. Lahat na nag-gather naming signature, pinapaintindi namin sa kanila that they will be part of this and be one of the petitioners of the People's Initiative.
Okay, notarized ba yung kada signature sheet?
Hindi po. But
so paano bagsak na kagad sa verified petition yun?
But as you see the signature sheet.
No, I'm just reacting, Madam Chair, to the inputs of Attorney Garbin. If all the signatories are to be treated as petitioners, bagsak na required. May we ask the COMELEC, doon po sa 10650 na sinuspend din nyo, ang petition ba to be filed on People's Initiative must be a verified petition?
Yes.
So we go back to the definition of what is a verification. All petitioners. So if the signature sheets and the signatories are treated as petitioners but these are not under oath, I think the theory already falls flat on its face.
Madam Chair, let me respond.
No,
the signatures will be part of the petition.
Madam Chair.